Hello and welcome to my channel. If you've been here before, welcome back. My name is Alfonso Peluso and I'm a studio associate professor in the College of Architecture at IIT, the home of the legendary Mies van der Rohe, and I'm adjunct faculty at Columbia College Chicago in the Interior Architecture program. Shout out to all my students. I hope you're having a great day and your semester is off to a good start. We're actually at midterm, just past midterm actually, depending on which school you're at. So we're either past midterm or close to midterm. Anyway, it is October 26th and we had some snowfall today. So we had our first snowfall of the winter of 2020-2021. It's not quite winter yet. It's still fall. We haven't even had Halloween yet. Today's video is going to look at using Blend in Revit. And as you can see, Blend is using two different shapes. So for instance, what I'm considering this column has a rectangular base and a rectangular top, but they're two different sizes. So same shape, but two different sizes in this case. And this little column, two different shapes. The bottom is a rectangle and the top is a circle. I prefer using the same shape, but you can do different shapes. You sometimes just, you know, you need to be aware of, you get some funky geometry. And in this one, these are two ellipses. So the bottom ellipse is bigger than the top ellipse. And then we have something that's more like a wall. So the bottom shape is different from the top shape, and we're able to blend those together. So it's similar to, if you use Rhino, it's similar to a loft command. All right, before we jump deep into the tutorial, if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, go ahead and click on the red subscribe bar. Click on the bell to receive all of the notifications. Love for you guys to take advantage of all the videos I have up here for you to learn from. Also, if you haven't connected with me on Instagram, connect with me at my first name Alfonso underscore my last name Peluso. See what my students are up to. See what kind of work they're producing. Some really great stuff here on the Instagram account. All right, let's jump into the tutorial. All right, I'm going to close down these files. And I'm going to open up a new project. And I'm going to make sure that this new project is an architectural template. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and turn on my project base point. So I'm going to use the shortcut VG for visibility and graphics. VG, no enter key. And I'm going to go down to site. And I'm going to go ahead and expand site. And I'm going to turn on project base point. All right, there's my project base point. So we're going to make that column that we made, or that you saw just a few minutes ago. So I'm going to Architecture. I'm going down to Component, and I'm choosing Model in Place. And I'm going to call this a generic model. And I'm going to name this one Blend 01. Oop, watch my spelling there. Blend 01. Alright. And I'm going to tell Revit that I want this to be a blend. So I'm going to click on Blend, and notice here this says Edit Top. So that means I'm drawing the base. I'm not drawing the top yet. So for all of these blends, you're going to draw a base and a top. So I'm going to draw a rectangle. I'm going to make this rectangle 2 feet. By 2 feet. I'm going to go ahead and move it back to the origin just by selecting it, typing in the shortcut MV for move, picking my point and putting it back on the project base point. Okay, so now I'm going to click Edit Top. Now notice it says Edit Base there. So I clicked Edit Top, I'm drawing the top. That's if I want to go back to edit the base. So I'm drawing the top of this rectangle blend structure. So I want it to be a little bit smaller. So I'm going to make this 1 foot 6 by 1 foot 6. And then to move it on top of the other one so that it's centered right above it, I'm just going to use some line geometry so that I can line those up. So I'm going to select all this, type in MV, and move it over. Revit's just warning me, telling me that I have some highlighted lines that overlap. Lines may not create closed loops. That's fine. I'm going to delete those two lines there. All right, so now I'm done. I can click on the check mark. And let's go ahead and look at this in a 3D view. Okay, so you see it's has this pyramid shape to it. I can stretch this and make this smaller or taller. And I'm going to go ahead and tell it that I want it to be 8 feet. Okay. All right. I'm going to go ahead and click on Finish Model. So I'm done with that column-like shape. So it's like a tapered column. I can always select it and drag the height lower so I can make this smaller or taller. But if I really want to see the size of it, I have to go to Edit in Place, select it, and then I'll see that actual height. Okay, so for the next one, let's actually draw another blend. So I had finished the model. I'm going to Architecture. I'm going to the down arrow for Component. I'm choosing Model in Place. I'm selecting a generic model category. I'm going to call this Blend 02. Tell it that I want it to be a blend. And I'm going to actually draw the little picture, that the little icon that they're using. So it's a square on the bottom and a circle on the top. And you can see more if I let that show there. There you see like a cross shape. So just need two profiles, two closed profiles. All right, so I'll make a square on the bottom. I'll make it 2 feet by 2 feet. And then I'm going to say Edit Top. Can't forget to do that. And I'm going to draw a circle. Draw it off to the side for now. I'm going to draw a line down here for my midpoint. And I'm going to take this and MV for move. Let's see if I can get a center point. There it is. Alright. Delete my line. And click on the green check mark. So that's the one that they're using in the actual picture. And I'm going to finish model. Alright, one more column, like, where I mentioned that I like to use the same shapes, just different sizes. So in this case, I'm going to draw the elliptical shape column. So generic models. Call this blend 03. And choose blend, and there is an ellipse tool. I'll make this 1 foot 6 by 12 inches, and then I'm going to draw another ellipse a little bit smaller. Oh, so that ellipse, that's on the same, those are both on edit base, so let me get rid of that one. And I forgot to click on Edit Top. Okay. I guess what warned me was they were both purple lines, so that let me know that they were part of the same base. Okay, so now I think I can draw a line across here. And a line across here. And I can line these up. Highlighted lines may overlap. Let's get rid of those. Alright, hit the green check mark. And there we go. We're good to go. All right, I'll finish the model. Okay, so let's go ahead and before we draw the wall shape structure, let's do a subtraction. We can do a subtraction with a blend. So blends don't always have to be vertical. They don't always have to be, you know, top, base top. They can be horizontal. So let's draw a horizontal one. So I'm going to go to, now, I want to subtract from this one. So if this is the one that I want to subtract from, I have to select it, choose Edit in Place, and then go over to Create Blend. Now I'm subtracting from this one. So I'm going to draw a circle, and I'm going to set my work plane to be pick a plane, and I'm going to pick that plane. So now when I draw, I'm drawing a circle on that column. Okay, edit top. Draw it from the center. I'll make it a little bit bigger. Yeah, I'm gonna make it big. Okay. So I wanna make sure that this goes all the way through. Okay, so that's going all the way through the column. And now I can go to cut. And now it's not going to let me cut because I haven't made this a, all of you at home are shouting, void. I haven't made that a void. So I have to go down and make that a void. Okay, now let's try cut. Okay, so there we go. Now we've cut through our column. Some pretty cool stuff there. Alright, I'm going to finish that model. Now we're going to do this with a wall shape. Okay, so let's go to Architecture. Let's go to Component, Model in Place. Let's choose Generic Models. I'm going to call this one Blend 04. I'm going to choose Blend, and I'm going to choose the Spline. Okay, I'll make a wall that wraps around these. Okay, so there's the bottom. Now it has to be closed loop, so I'm going to choose an offset of 3 inches, which is not the default. The default usually a foot, so 3 inches. And that's going to be a copy. So let's get in here. It might not like my knot that I drew on this thing. There we go. Alright, I'm going to close that off. Do the same thing on this side. Close loop. Okay, so that's the base. Now I want to draw the top, so edit top. Lines must be in closed loop, so right there it's open. Let's see if I got it this time. Nope. So let me show you guys a trick. I wanted to show you this before. There's a command called TL, which will show you the thin lines. So sometimes it's easier to draw these with TL, with thin lines turned on, then I can get my endpoint snap. Go to edit top. Alright, so let's draw the top of this. Again, I'm gonna do this with a spline, so instead of wrapping around, I'm going to come inside these. So I'm going to make this wavy wall, and I'm going to offset this 3 inches, and I'm going to close it. Zoom in to close it. Okay. Let's lift that up. All right. It's interfering a little bit with the column right now. It's all right, we can move it. So let's drag that out a little bit. There we go. All right, let's finish that model. There we go. We have that beautiful wavy wall structure. All right, let's look at printing. Let's print this to a PDF. All right, let's go to File. We'll go to Print. Adobe PDF is chosen. I'm going to go to Properties and decide what my paper size is going to be. For some of you, that's letter, tabloid. For me, it's going to be 4x10. Did I choose the right one? No, I didn't. 4x10. Okay. And visible portion of current window is going to work for me. And I can click Preview. So you see it sitting on the 4x10 sheet. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you found it helpful, click on a like below. Leave me a comment of what you liked about the video. My head's going to pop up in the upper left. You can click on my head if you haven't subscribed yet. And I'm going to leave some videos, some Revit videos for you in the upper right and the lower right. Have a great one, and I'll see you on the next one.